Hi everyone, this is Brendan here and welcome to my next episode, Day 9 of my Let's Clash series. So now as you can see, I'm being attacked. This is a defense replay. So what happens was, well, this guy was using all archers to attack me. And all archers is really a nice strategy to use. However, I do not like to use all archers because there's no mid shield in front of the archers to tank against the damage. Especially now you can see on the top of there, the cannons, although they are only like level 1 and 2, they are taking out the archers really quickly. This is why I prefer to use barbarians in my army combo. Especially when I do barbarian archers or even a BAM, which is a barbarian archers and minions. But still, this is a good strategy to use, as now you can see he took out the structures on the outside. But if he had some mid shield, like some barbarians or giants, he would be able to 3-star my base. So now removing one obstacle and heading back to my base. And as you can see, I decided to upgrade the barrack to the next level, level 5. As I'm on my way to Townhall6 and there isn't a need for me to farm that much to prepare for Townhall6, as I'm almost to the max amount of gold capacity. So as you can see now, my first raid that I'd like to show you guys, this 160 over 1000 gold available. The raid that that happened to me just now, the first one that you guys just watched, the defense replay, I actually lost 123,000 gold. However, if I'm able to get all the gold from this particular raid itself, I will be able to recuperate back all the lost gold, and also be able to stock up some gold, at the same time be able to get some elixir. So I decided to drop my troops on the top left side and also the bottom right side because my elixir was running out really quickly. So I wanted to stock them up to prepare for Townhall6. So deploying my troops on the bottom right too to clear out more of the structures and also trying to get the percentage up. And then eventually, as you can see now, it's at 40% with the opponent's shield being activated. So shield for the opponent will be activated once the town hall has been destroyed or 40% or more damage has been done. So seeing that I've gotten the 1-star, I decided to end the battle right now and then eventually having to keep 15 barbarians and 3 archers for my next battle. So this particular base, as you can see, is 194,000 gold and 161,000 elixir. It's not too easy to attack, but it's also not that difficult. So I decided to attack from the bottom. Why I didn't attack from the top is because the mortar is over there. So I was hoping that the balloon could actually take out some of the air targeting defenses first, and then eventually the balloon could fly up there to take out the mortar. However, the air defense on the top would probably take the balloon out, so not to worry. Hopefully the spread of my troops will be able to distract the mortar long enough before they actually get taken out. And my balloon has been taken out by the air defense on the top. So now as you can see, my troops are just pouring in. The barbarians have broken through the black level 4 walls. And now the mortar is really in a big trouble. When the barbarians are close enough, the mortar won't be able to hit them because there's like a dead zone area, the red color zone area. If you guys were to click on the defense, the mortar itself, you'll be able to see that there's a red area around the defense itself, and that's where the mortar can't actually shoot. So that's something that I like to use, which is using my barbarians to try to get as close as possible to the mortar, then after that dropping my archers once the mortar have gone down. So that's something that I really like to use, especially when the mortar is exposed, being outside, just left alone there. So dropping like 2 to 3 barbarians will be able to take it out if there's no other defenses protecting it. So back to our base. So now as you can see, I'm upgrading another barrack to try to increase the housing space available so that it'll be easier for me to train troops, at the same time unlocking more troops. So now this base, as you can see, has 206,000 gold and 120,000 elixir. Elixir wasn't too much of a problem for me. As you can see on the top right, I'm almost capped on elixir right now, having 351,000 in my storage only, whereas the gold is currently is at 1 million capacity already. So I'm trying to stock up the gold to prepare for my next town hall level, which is Townhall6. So carrying on the attack, as you can see, I was focusing a lot on the gold mines itself, as I can see that they are very full from the crate at the very bottom of the gold mine. And then now focusing my troops all over there, spreading my troops to try to take out as many of the gold mines as possible, and also stealing a bit of the elixir to try to get my elixir storage to the max capacity right now at 351,000. So now my goal, as you can see, is at 940,000, almost reaching to 1 million. However, even if I steal all the loot on this base itself, I won't be able to get my gold storage to max, which is 1 million. So just letting the raid just carrying on, and then my balloon just flying above, taking out all those ground attacking defenses, and then nothing be able to take the balloon out. So just left the last army camp being taken out, scoring us the 3 stars. So that was really nice. So back to my base. So as you can see, I upgraded elixir storage. Another builder was ready from the finished upgrade of the barracks itself. And then now finding another 300 over 1000 gold base. So definitely I wanted to go for it because I just need 200,000 gold to fill up my storage to the cap of 1 million. And then just going ahead to attack with 345,000 gold available too. So spreading my troops on the top right to take out and focus on the gold mines. And also deploying some archers on the right side to take out the gold mines. Decided to drop some barbarians to take out the air defense structure over there so that my balloons could actually fly around without any harm from the air defense itself. And then just continuing to steal a lot of the loot, stole all the loot from the gold mines, just left with only 300,000 gold for this guy. Basically the gold storage has already been kept, reaching at 1 million. So both of the resources are at cap right now. So I'm ready for my Townhall6. Hopefully I'll be able to use the resources on the Townhall6. And then after that, just continue the attack, trying to just get a slightly more loot to just increase my profile, as they're in technically a need to get more loot ready, it will just overflow. So just letting my troops just run about to just finish the raid. And also with the balloon flying around, it'll be able to take out the last defensive structure, the mortar. Then once it has gone down, I know that it's gonna be a 3 stars. So I left this last elixir collector, we took it out and scored us the 3 star on this Townhall 7. So back to my base, decided to upgrade my barrack again so that I could increase the housing speed. And after 3 hours and 26 minutes, I came back online and then I waited for my town hall to get to level 6. In just 3, 2, 1, boom, we got to level 6. So Townhall 6 is really fun to play because there will be more stuff to work on also. Definitely trying to get to Townhall 7 or Townhall 8, and I know most of you guys are saying that I'm rushing my base, this and that. However, the reason why I'm rushing my base is because I'm trying to get to Townhall 9 as soon as possible so that I could focus a lot on the walls, because Townhall 9, you will have a lot of walls to upgrade, that's one, and also the walls cost a lot to upgrade them to the max possible level for Townhall 9, which is level 10 walls. And then it will cost really a lot because of it having 2 levels to upgrade, level 8 to level 10, which will cost a total of 4 million gold per piece of wall, which totals up to 250 pieces of wall times 4 million, which will have a total of 1 billion resources needed to actually farm the walls. So that's something that I'm really focusing on. I do not really care about defenses, because even if I lose the defense and get all my loot stolen, I will be able to get it back in roughly 1-2 attacks. So like this particular one, as you can see, I'm just getting back all the loot that I've lost from my defense itself. Not too worried about loot, to be honest, seriously. I know most of you guys are really concerned about me losing my loot. At the same time, you guys want me to upgrade the defenses to max them for a particular town hall itself. However, I'm really not going to do that because that's not how I actually play Clash. I usually just focus on the stuff that's able to upgrade in the most optimum manner, which currently now is at the walls. So when I started Clash last time, this is how I actually played too, focusing on walls, trying to get them as high as possible. And I'm not sure some of you may believe or not, but last time when I hit Town Hall 9 for my main account, I actually had level 3, level 2, and in fact level 1 air defenses on my base, having like even low level mortar, low level wizard towers, they are like level 3 or so. And then the archer towers and the cannons, they were also very low in level. But the walls, they were pretty much like max, as in like town hall, level 8 walls for that particular town hall itself. That's why I proceeded on into going into town hall 9 that early. And I know you guys will be saying I rushed my town hall this and, but if you actually know how long it takes to actually upgrade the walls, it costs 2.3 billion gold or elixir. Last time it couldn't use a gold to upgrade, so it cost 2.3 billion gold to upgrade the walls, which is the most expensive stuff in the game. That's why I was focusing a lot on walls, and I didn't want to delay the walls upgrade, as the walls, they can upgrade within just a few seconds. Don't have to wait for the time. The builders basically can just upgrade the walls instantly, not needing to wait for like a day or even 2 days, or in fact even 14 days for that matter, when the structures become high in level, and then after you have to wait 14 days for a particular defense itself. So the walls, you can just upgrade them instantly. That's why I usually do the walls first before I proceed into upgrading my other defenses, so that I could use up all the gold, use up all the resources, and then eventually when I upgrade the defense or the structure that I want, I'll be left with almost no resources. And then when I go offline, when people try to attack me, they won't be able to take a lot of loot out of me. So now selling some of the flex, so now upgrading the clan castle, getting it to the next level, level 3, so that I could get more housing spaces to get stronger troops for my, from my clan mates. And then now, as you can see, I attack this base. Having only like a few thousand gold left, I attack this base so that I could get back the gold and then eventually be able to do more proper raids, because I have to have enough gold to be able to search for raids. So attacking from the bottom and trying to focus my troops on the bottom right, as the gold mines were all there and they look pretty full. The gold storages, as usual, they are empty. That's why I usually attack and focus on the gold mines for this kind of cases. So just going ahead, the town has already gone down, gotten the 1 star, maybe even going for the 2 stars right now. So just going ahead, a lot of traps in the middle of the base, and there's a giant bomb over there, took out a lot of my troops. However, just carrying on, taking out some of the gold mines already, and then just left with only 20,000 gold inside the base itself. Didn't really bother to go for it anymore. In fact, I had a lightning spell, which some people would say they would want to use the lightning spell to get maybe more elixir out of it. However, for this particular base, the elixir collectors ain't really full, and also I don't really need elixir that much, so it didn't make sense for me to use a lightning spell on this particular base itself. I do lightning some resources last time, as to when the resources, they're all packed together, and then eventually when you drop one lightning spell, you could get like 100,000 over resources out of it. So maybe in time to come, we will actually see such rates. So let's focus on this particular rate. So as you can see, the resources are really high, and then eventually there was a town hall on the left side too. Decided to snipe it first, definitely, so that I could score the win, and then eventually deploying my troops to focus on the gold mines, because I just needed gold. The elixir wasn't too much of a problem for me. I was trying to get my gold up so that I could get my upgrades done even more, and also to upgrade my walls even more. So focusing on the gold, is now left with 137,000. Managed to take all the gold from the gold mine. And then now just having a little fun, just drop my clan castle so that I could take out some more of the structures. And then eventually I was just waiting for the town hall to just go down. So just wait for the town hall to go down, and then eventually once a bit more of the structures has gone down, we will speed things a bit up so that we do not wait for the town hall to go down. So we'll just fast forward a bit. Town hall has gone down, scoring us the 1 star, and then eventually ending the battle 30%. So another base, as you can see, this has 256,000 gold. And I know a lot of you guys will be asking me, how did I find such a high resources base this easily or whatsoever. To be honest, it's not that difficult to find, especially at such a low town hall level, that's one. And then of course, the trophy range that I'm at is at 1,000 to 1,200. So this trophy range for a Townhall6 is really nice to farm at. And then able to find high resources bases such as this one. If I find a Townhall8, Townhall7, basically the loot will be very high. However, if once I reach to like Townhall10, and then I find like a Townhall8, the loot will be half. So it's not very difficult to find a high resources basis, that's one. And of course, it's down to luck. And usually I take around 2 to 3 minutes, or maybe even 5 minutes to find such bases to attack. So it's not all the time, like I take maybe 10 seconds or whatsoever to find such bases. But of course, there are times whereby I'm very lucky, and then it takes like maybe only 5 nicks, maybe around 30 seconds to find a base. So it just depends on luck, depends on the timing also. So that's it for all the raids that I'd like to show you guys for this particular episode. Hopefully I'll be able to update you guys tomorrow and show you guys the upgrades on the walls. Hopefully be able to get most of them to like pink walls. I doubt I'll be able to get all the walls to pink walls, as I have a lot of walls to upgrade, as I've been given more walls to upgrade once I reach to Townhall6. So hopefully you guys will stay tuned for it. And with that said, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my video and clash on. And also do enjoy this last 3-star raid on this particular base itself.